are you?
Good.
How much do you think that that Michigan game was just kind of, you know, a bunch of new guys in a tough environment and not being able to close it out in that situation?
I think it was part of it, you know. I think we started out really well, especially defensively. The first 32, 34 minutes of the game, we were winning by, I think, 15. And then, you know, just hit a couple of threes, and then the home environment took over and they won the game. So yeah, I think it was definitely part of it. So next time we're gonna be better.
How has this season kind of changed for you with the the trajectory of not having the three guys here so far, and obviously your role's gotten bigger? How has this kind of changed your role on this team?
Well, we never really had it. So they didn't miss a game. So they got suspended before the first game, so I don't really know how it would look if they were there, but it definitely changed a lot of our team. Our depth is pretty much gone, so especially for the bigs, it's only like 3 or 4 of us, so it definitely puts a little more pressure on us, but you know, it's just adversity, so you gotta get through that.
Coach just said that there could be some resolution to that, that you guys could find out whether you could get those guys back or not. Maybe by as early as the end of the week. For you guys, how nice would that be to have that sort of resolution to know, sort of kind of finish that distraction?
Well, it would be nice to know, you know, because, you know, the past couple of months it's just been up in the air and we don't really know what's going on, so it'd be definitely nice to know when they're going to be back.
You played for the national team this summer. How did that kind of help you? What did you kind of develop and work on?
I think mainly my confidence, and it was just a good experience to play against pros and older guys, because they know all the tricks of the game, you know. So it was definitely a good experience, but I'm trying to focus on UCLA right now, so it definitely helped, but it's a different type of game over there.
You said that those guys got suspended before the season started, so they didn't miss any games. But even so, you went through the entire summer with those guys, expecting them to be there.
Oh yeah, yeah. We had a team during the summer, and we were pretty together. It was nice to have them, and so definitely it hurt the team, just like I said. And our depth is gone, but you know, we haven't missed any game. I mean, they haven't missed any games, so the game wise, it's just been the same.
Is that style that you played in Hungary similar to what the Vols will be facing Lithuania?
A little bit similar, I think. Lithuania, as far as I know, they usually have good competition there. It's a good league. I'm not sure about the team that they went to, what leagues are they in. I don't know if they're in the Euro League or any international league. Are they in the Baltic League? I'm not sure. But Lithuania is usually have pretty good basketball culture, so they should be okay, I think. I'm not sure what the team is like, though.
What do you think about the way the young players, the freshmen who are still here, like Chris Wilkes, Jalen Hands, and Chris Smith, how do you think they're developing so far? They just finished their first road game.
I think they're developing great, you know. I think you know, everybody's... When I first got in, there was a lot of things I had to get used to, you know. It's just a completely different type of game. You don't have as much time to make decisions on the court, and I think that's a really big part. And it's a really big adjustment that they had to make, that everybody has to make when we join the NCAA. So I think they're doing great.
Thank you, G.